Well, howdy, y'all. This is Clay.
And I am Lloyd.
And this is Iron Sharpening Iron with the Kahler Boys. Today is what? What is today?
Today's Thursday.
It is Thursday. You can always tell it's Thursday.
Most. I'll tell you what today is.
Today?
Today is my wife's stroke birthday.
Oh, wow.
Both of them.
Really? Yeah, that's right.
2014.
Yeah.
She had a stroke.
Right.
August 22nd, about 8, 9 o'clock in the morning. 7 years later,
yep.
She had another stroke about 8 or 9 o'clock in the morning.
I remember that second one very well.
7 years to the, almost to the minute. And yep. Then today is 10 years ago.
Wow.
And I don't know, since that stroke, needless to say, our life changed drastically.
Well, yeah. Yeah, not only physically, but for you.
But man,
That stroke brought you to Christ.
I can't say. That's what I'm going to get to. I can't say that my life changed for the worse.
No.
Matter of fact, my life changed for the better.
Yeah.
And so did hers in a lot of ways.
Yeah. Yeah, well.
In a lot of ways.
Yeah, her husband became a believer.
And just.
Child of God.
Yeah, and then just the cascade of things since then.
Yeah.
And continuing and just, I don't know.
Yeah.
Just good stuff.
Yeah, it is.
Today's also like Mason, my middle grandson.
Yeah.
Was his first day of school like in 2015.
Oh, wow.
Or 16, something like that. And he's marching off to a whole new class of schools now.
Today is also the final day of the demonic national convention going on in Chicago right now.
Oh, praise God on that. Thank God it's the last day.
Your
22nd of August.
Your girl. Kamala Harris is going to accept the nomination that she never got. How do you accept a nomination that nobody voted for?
Well, because Trump's going to ruin democracy.
That's right. Yeah, you have to destroy democracy in order to save it.
You know, if you look back at some of the crazy Marxist writings way back in the day and whatever, it says that in there.
Yeah.
It says that in there in order to build a good system, you have to ruin a good system.
That's right.
Something to that effect. Yeah, you got to destroy.
Oh,
yeah, build back better.
Yeah, build back
better. I want to know something. If she has got all these promises about fixing everything on day one, what's she been doing for the last 3.5 years?
Right.
Whose mess is she fixing?
Right.
Whose troubles is she taking care of? You know, most time when a new president rolls in the White House, they're like, you know what? That last guy was an idiot, and a lot of times they're correct.
Yeah.
And I've got to undo and redo a whole bunch of stuff.
But she can say the same thing.
She was right next to the last guy.
It doesn't matter. He's still an idiot.
In her own words. I was the last person out of the room.
That's right.
I was always the last person out of the room.
Oh, my God.
Were you the last person out of the room in the Afghanistan debacle?
Yep.
Yes, she was.
Yep.
By her own admission, the border czar.
Oh, man. Let's do scripture of the day.
All right.
And then let's go nuts. Let's go. Oh, by the way, I had somebody come up to me yesterday at church, and she looked at me imploringly, looked into my eyes, and said, "You and Lloyd need to do 3 or 4 podcasts a week. One's not enough."
You know, I have often seen something, and I mean often, since we've started this. The last 3 months, especially.
Yeah.
I've often seen something that went on during the day, or something that happened, or something that carried on, or some news that broke, and thought, I wish our jobs were different, that we could do it. Call you up and say, emergency broadcast.
Yeah, right.
We need to do a podcast right now and cover this.
Right.
I'm headed over, you know, but unfortunately, you know, fortunately.
Yeah.
Fortunately, we have very fulfilling lives and jobs and fortunately, we can squeeze an hour out of each week.
Right. Yeah, and that's pretty much what I told her. I said, look, the two of us both sacrifice just to get this 1 hour a week. You know,
we squeeze it.
Our lives are rough. All right.
Come on now.
I ain't complaining.
Well, rough would be the wrong word. Blessed.
Blessed, absolutely.
But hectic, busy.
Yeah,
we're
there
full.
You go.
We're
that's
full.
It.
We're
that's
hectic,
it. Full.
And busy. But there ain't none of
full.
It. There ain't none of it that.
Full.
Yeah.
Yeah, full.
We're busy, and that's good stuff, man.
Yeah.
I wouldn't get rid of none of it. I'm, of course, not going to get rid of my job.
No.
You know, kind of need that, unless I'm a Democrat. But and you know, I have the privilege of taking care of my bride,
right,
and helping her with things, and I get to take my mother,
yeah,
to water aerobics.
Yeah,
I mean, I get to.
Yeah, your wife and your mother.
I would love one time to take the old man hunting again.
Oh, I know.
Can't do
I
it.
Know.
Can't do it. That's not a possibility.
Not an option.
So I cherish these full days.
Yeah.
I cherish them.
Well, and you know, between my full time job and then the church,
you got lots on your plate
and everything in between. And like you, I am so blessed. Every Sunday after church, I get to take our mama and our sister Cindy, and we go to Jimmy's Egg every Sunday after church.
You get to aggravate them people up there.
Oh, I have such a good time up there. I got to share this with you. You're going to like this.
They love you up there.
I like this. You're going to like this. There is this old timer up there, and I do mean old timer. Little old fella, and I see him up there just about every time I go in. He's there every Sunday.
He's more of a regular than you are.
Well, he and his bride, he and his little wife. If I go to Jimmy's Egg, there's a 99% chance I'm going to see these two.
Cool.
And this old man sits up there with his Trump ball cap on. And I went over to him one day, and I shook his hand, told him how much I liked his ball cap. And we struck up a friendship. And so every time I go in and he's in there, and they're in there, I go over and visit with him for a little while. And I went in one day, and they were sitting there, and he didn't have his cap on. I said, "Hey, where's your ball cap?" And he said, "Oh, I forgot it." So in that moment, I realized I needed to make this dude a ball cap. And so I made him one of these.
Oh, that'll work. He'll love it.
Yeah. Well, I already gave it to him.
Oh.
Yeah. I went up there, and I had it in the truck, and I saw their vehicle. And so I grabbed the ball cap, and I walked over, and I was talking to him. And I said, I made something for you. I said, keep this one in your vehicle, and that way if you forget the other one, you'll have this one. And I handed it to him. This dude welled up in tears, immediately ripped his ball cap off, put that one on.
Put the new one on. Got to fixing it, too, didn't
you? Right. That's right. Let's do scripture of the day.
All right.
This is, I was telling you off camera, Lloyd, this is the passage that we studied last night. And I don't know that I've ever done this. We spent the entire hour on two verses. There's so much depth here. Obviously, we're not going to be able to go deep into it like we did last night. But if you want to see last night's Bible study, go to Red River Cowboy Church, Burke Burnett on Facebook, and you can see it. Paul says this, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, beginning in verse 20. He says, "Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ. As though God were pleading through us, we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him." He, the Father, made him, the Son, who knew no sin, to be sin for us, that we might be the righteousness of God in him. That is so deep. And I mean, we dove into that last night. And brother, I'm telling you, it just chills me to the bone. You know, I'll get into just a little bit and then we'll move on. But you study Matthew and the crucifixion scene in Matthew. And Jesus cried out, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani? My God, why have you forsaken me?" And a lot of people wonder why he cried that out. Well, keep in mind, Jesus was born of a virgin, born sinless, born perfect, lived a perfect life, tempted in every way that we are, but yet never sinned.
Right.
Was nailed to that cross. And in that moment that he cried out, my God, why have you forsaken me? He took upon himself all of the sin of the world. And for the first time in his humanity, he felt separation from God.
And because of the sin. Sin is what separates you
from God. Yeah, that sin, when it was piled on him, the Father had to look away. And he had never felt that separation before. And I went through it this way last night. I said, on October 7th, animals attacked Israel. raped, murdered, burned alive, and beheaded men, women, and children. That sin was cast on Christ on that cross. All sin.
All sin, yeah. All
sin. Hitler.
Present, past, future, all sin.
Pol Pot.
All sin. Lenin. I can't even just imagine. Just the sin of this world.
Yeah.
God, you look at your own community and you think, wow, that's pretty rough.
Look at my own life. My own sin is too much to bear.
Yeah. And then you look at, then you multiply that by this planet.
And listen to the way
and all, of all time.
And listen to the way that Paul put this. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us.
And we think our plates are full.
Yeah.
Boy, that kind of puts you in a humbling spot, don't it?
It does.
It don't make my life pretty good.
It does. Then notice the flip side of this, though, that we might become the righteousness of God for him.
Amen.
In the moment, Lloyd, in that moment at Legacy Church, that you found yourself at the foot of a bloodstained cross and you accepted the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus, in that moment, God stripped your sin, nailed it to the cross in the person of Jesus, and enclothed you in Christ's own righteousness.
And that passage that's in the Bible that you get, that peace that surpasses
all understanding. And guard your hearts and your minds.
I knew exactly what that felt.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And in that moment, I felt almost like a physical wave.
Yeah.
That everything was good.
Yeah.
Everything was, nothing had changed. I'm going to cry. Good Lord.
I see it coming.
Nothing had changed in the natural world.
Right.
Nothing.
But eternity nothing. Had changed.
Zero.
Eternity Zero, had changed though. In that moment.
Zero.
Right.
Changed in the natural world.
Right.
Brandy was still sick.
Yep.
Brandy was still laying in that bed and couldn't talk, couldn't walk, couldn't eat.
Yep.
All she could do was breathe.
Yep.
The girl's mother was still not coming home.
Right.
Nothing had changed in the natural world. But I knew in a blink, in an instant, everything was going to be all right. And I had never in my entire life thought that.
Right.
Ever. Ever. Ever.
Isn't that
ever.
Amazing? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Beyond amazing, dude. I was looking at that shit, thinking about that moment last night while I was up. You know, I was off last night. So
yeah.
I was sitting up doing nothing a lot of the night. And I was thinking about that moment that came to my mind. Came to my mind because I was seeing such the evilness going on in Chicago.
I know it. I know it, man.
They ain't trying to get so it started earlier, but that's what triggered my moment.
Yeah.
Was seeing that. I was looking at these videos, and I got off the videos.
Yeah, you had to.
Yeah. Just, well, God showed me my moment. He's like, wait a minute. You're just dwelling into ugly and ugly and ugly.
Oh, yeah.
And I was becoming not angry and I'm just disgusted about it. I mean, I am disgusted.
Oh, and angry.
But
and rightly so.
It was wrapping me up.
Yeah. Though. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And then all of a sudden,
it's consuming. All of a
sudden, that moment, September 7th,
yep.
came to my mind. What were you doing September 7th at 12:30?
Yeah.
I know what I was doing.
Yeah.
And that was 10 years ago.
Wow.
10 years ago.
That
was right after Randy's stroke. So
thank you, Lord.
2014, September 7th, about 12:30 in the afternoon, I know what I was doing.
Yeah.
I was being washed clean by the blood of Christ.
Oh, I'm telling you, man.
Oh, and then I couldn't wait to get to her.
Right.
I couldn't wait to get to her.
You know, and Sally.
Well, Sally was there.
Okay.
But she wasn't with me.
Right.
She was there. But you know what? I just now thought about that. I never even went to Sally.
Really?
I blew right past her and everybody
else. To get to Brandy. Yeah.
Pastor John stopped me. And he said, I don't know your name. And I said, you will. When do the doors open? Whoo, I will cry. Good Lord. When do the doors open? And he told me. And I said, thank you. And I took off. I turned and went. I didn't talk to Sally. Nobody went and got in my truck and drove to Brandy. And the nurses thought something was wrong. They thought she was hurt or something was wrong. Because I just went in there and crawled right on top of that bed with her and just was hugging and loving on her.
Oh, yeah.
And hooting and hollering and telling her that I was wrong. Never in my life have I ever been wanting to admit I was wrong so bad.
So happy to admit that you were wrong.
Couldn't wait to get there.
Yeah.
How many of you guys couldn't wait to admit to your wife that you were wrong?
Oh, man. God is so good. I'm telling you.
All the time, dude. All the time. Look around, look around, look around.
And you know, it's easy to forget that when you see this garbage that's going on in our world. What's going on in Chicago? What's going on in our government? But you know, it's all right here. It's all right here. You know, the enemy is going to use the world leaders to bring about what he's trying to bring about. And
how would you do it if you were the enemy? That's a good strategic plan.
I would recruit Tim Walz. That's what I would do.
Yeah.
He's a prime candidate.
Boy. You know, I don't know if we talked about this last week or not. There's a scary thing going on.
It's a lot of scary things.
Yeah, but this is particularly
come on with
troubling.
It. Come on with it.
I think we did, but I'm not sure. They either checked into Tim Walz, vetted his background.
Right.
And said,
yeah, that's our guy.
Yeah, well, he had pitted neighbor against neighbor with the hotline.
Oh, I know it, man.
On COVID restriction. He sent troops armed in tactical gear down the road to shoot at civilians during the George Floyd riot.
Right.
He let Minneapolis burn. He let a lot of Minnesota burn.
Yeah.
He called off the National Guard and the police.
And his bride raised the windows.
Relished.
So she could smell the burning tires.
I wonder if she's got that scent marketed yet. You know, burning tires of progression.
You know, they honeymooned
in incense
in China. And Tim Walz and his wife honeymooned in China. And their wedding anniversary is the date of Tiananmen Square.
Yeah, there's nothing fishy about it.
No!
See, so they either vetted him and was like, that's our dude.
Yeah.
Or they didn't.
They didn't care.
Either way, it was
because
scary.
The fix is in.
That's it. And every time I see something else new about stolen valor or stolen whatever, just everything, I just, my theory of either the fix is in or they have no intention of having an election at all.
Just sorry about that, y'all.
Just gets more and more because, I mean, you know, Brandy's best friend lives a couple doors down, Miss Emily.
Yeah, yeah.
Good morning, Miss Emily.
Good girl.
And she's one of our subscribers.
Yeah.
And we were talking about that the other day, you know. And she said, why do you think the fix is in? I said, well, let me ask you something, man. Let me put you in a situation. You are now a basketball coach. A basketball coach.
Right.
And you have these.
Unlike Tim, who was an assistant football coach.
That got fired because he got the DW.
Yeah.
He's on the Democratic convention. He was announced as a championship football coach. That's just everything about him.
I know.
And he just stands up and goes, that's me. I'd be like, well, no, dude. That's the wrong script. All that ain't me. How am I going to talk about that? You know, one of the nurses, he's my little brother. He flies a spy plane.
That's right. You know? That's right. And
he invented the internet and
created the cure for polio.
Yeah. But and you go, that's me. So yeah. how'd you create that cure?
I was cooking biscuits one day.
Well, you have no idea because it really wasn't you. But anyway, Emily was asking, she said, why do you think that? So I told her, I said, you're a basketball coach, okay?
Yeah.
And your next game coming up, you know these two opponents that you got coming up, and you get to pick anybody in the United States mm-hmm. to be on your team. Anybody.
Anybody.
Anybody. It's wide open. And I said, so you find out that your two opponents are, we'll say, they're the number two and number three.
Michael Jordan and LeBron James.
No, they're too old. Jordan's too dang old. We'll just say they're the number two and number three ranked NBA player in the NBA today.
Right.
Number two and number three, not even a number one guy. You're going against the number two and number three top-ranked player in the NBA right now. I'd call them pretty good.
Yeah.
Pretty good. Pretty good at basketball.
Top of their game.
I'd venture to say they're pretty good at any sport. They're probably pretty athletic. Probably pretty fast. They can probably jump high. They can probably, you know, they've got really good eye-hand coordination. You know, they're pretty good at their game.
That reminded me of something I'll have to bring up on your W illustration.
And I said, so now, Emily, you look at that and you say, okay, that's the team I got. I'm against. So let me pick. I said, would you pick, and I think I used me and you.
Yeah.
Would you pick me and my little brother to go against them? I said, we're good old boys, but we're not very good at basketball.
Uh-uh.
We're not young. I can't run for nothing. And my vertical is about that high if I only do it off one leg. If right. I try to jump off both legs, it hurts too bad. I said, I don't think Clay's much better.
No.
He can run a little faster, but not for very long distance.
Uh-uh.
I said, because, you know, that something about, I don't know, being shot out and crammed in a tank and all this other stuff that he's been through his entire life has wore him down. And he's over 50. I said, would you pick us two or would you pick somebody else? I said, your answer would be somebody else unless it didn't matter who you picked, the fix was in.
Right.
As soon as they dribbled the ball out, double dribble.
Yep.
You know, turnover. And as soon as they come up and tried to guard me, foul, shoot the foul. And the fix was in, and they don't have a chance.
Right.
There's no possible way.
When the most valuable player on your team is the referee.
Yes. And it would be those two against the entire fix, and they would lose no matter what.
Right.
I said, you could put in B.J. Morgan, and they'd lose.
Yeah.
You know, me and B.J. Dang, B.J., you're supposed to catch it. You got it with your face again.
All right.
And I love B.J. Morgan, by the way.
Oh, yeah,
and she just kind of looked at me, and I was like, so – then you look at all the problems of these two candidates.
Oh, gosh. And they are endless.
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 And I said, doesn't make no sense.
Uh-uh.
I said, these are educated people making these picks. I said, and then, you know, Kamala, oh, it's hard not to call her that other name.
I know.
It just is.
Commie.
Commie Harris there is didn't even get picked. She got placed.
Yeah. Well, and here's the thing, man. When you have a ticket, and you've got a bad candidate, the way you countermand that bad candidate is with bringing in an amazing candidate.
Yeah.
You know, if they would have brought in Joe Manchin as VP, or somebody like that, you know, somebody who is
what was
middle
that
of the
pick they wanted.
Oh, Shapiro.
Shapiro.
Yeah. He's just as bad. But on paper, he'd
have been better.
Yeah.
On paper, he's not there lying about being a coach, getting DWIs, stealing Valor and everything else.
But they couldn't pick him because he's a Jew.
I know.
And you can't have a Jew because we're pro-Palestine.
And, yeah.
So this is the memory that you brought up when you were talking about the fact that number two and number three NBA players be good at any sport. And it immediately reminded me of high school. In high school, do you remember when the Dallas Cowboys came to Burke Burnett and played against our high school basketball team.
I do.
Oh, man, that was fun. And I remember the posters hanging up in the hallway, and it was a cartoon of a Dallas Cowboy holding a basketball, and he looked confused, and he says, but it's round. And they beat the crap out of our boys.
Well,
yeah. It was
and you remember the big ticket dude that, because like the huge stars, the big time Cowboys didn't show up. I think a couple names, but it was
Goldilocks Henderson.
No, not Henderson, Richardson.
No, Goldilocks Henderson, because remember he stayed at the house like four doors down from on Tejas.
I think you're confusing two people.
Am I?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Yeah. Henderson. Well, that's a different guy.
There were two Hendersons. One of them was one of the Terrible Towel, and then the other one was Goldilocks. Goldilocks Henderson, I'm pretty sure. If not, then I have been telling this story wrong all my life. But who cares? They're Cowboys. They're Dallas Cowboys. Nobody cares about Dallas Cowboys. 1996, y'all. You know what 1996 is, right?
Yeah.
Their last appearance in the Super Bowl was in 1996.
Yeah. Golden Richards.
That's a different person.
No.
It was Goldilocks. Not Golden. Anyway, let's move on.
But
look. I don't want to burn up our time.
I don't either, but that's him. And they called him Goldilocks. But that's him.
I don't think so.
Yeah, well, you'd be wrong.
My memory is far better than your Google.
Oh, man. Wow.
Oh. So.
Wow.
One of the things going on in Chicago right now is you have the mobile butcher shop.
That is unbelievable.
Planned Parenthood has a taco truck that they have parked outside of the venue, or in the venue outside of the building. And they are offering free vasectomies.
Which I'm all in favor of.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Crowd. Yes. You know, Bob Barker used to close out every...
I thought he was going to wait.
Every Price is Right, and he would say, spay and neuter your pets. And now, apparently, it's spay and neuter your liberals. But anyway, and I'm all in favor of that. Free vasectomies and free abortions.
And they're boasting about how many they've done.
Yeah. Monday, they murdered 10 babies. And Tuesday, they murdered 15 babies. So, as of...
And inside the convention, they're talking about joy.
Oh, it's joy. Joy. Yeah, the joy.
How joyful is it to be outside killing the children?
Yeah. Standing in line at a Planned Parenthood taco truck to have this child dismembered and ripped out of your womb.
Well, you know, Tim Walz signed... Yeah. Law that you can, if they're born accidentally aborted,
if they survive the abortion,
you're just to leave them lay there and they'll just die in a little while.
Yeah.
After a while.
Yeah.
Just leave them. Yeah. Like, you know, anything you just leave lay to die in a little while. If we took Tim Walz outside and just left him lay down, in a little while he'd die.
Yeah, we could. The old Apaches, they used to stake you down over an anthill and cover you in honey.
I also used to stake you down and get a little bit of entrail, cut you right here,
right.
Get a little bit of intestine and pull out.
Mm-hmm.
And the coyote would pull the rest.
Yeah, that's
and
right.
You're alive while they're doing that.
That's right. It just,
you know, we're headed back to bringing back the old ways. I don't know if them are going to make it, but
right.
Never can tell.
They worship abortion. They worship environment. They worship all. They have. It's a religion, man.
And they call it healthcare. I can't get over that.
Girl. I know, man.
It
is the only medical procedure that guarantees the death of somebody. And here's the thing with going back to Tampon Tim and letting these babies lay there and die. If somebody in the state of Minnesota had puppies born. And they just abandoned them and let them die?
They'd be thrown in
they
jail
would be
with
thrown
a felony.
In jail.
With a felony.
Yeah.
And multiple counts if it was multiple dogs.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because Tampon Tim cares more about the dogs than he does about human life, and that's obvious. I don't know. I saw, you know about an ironic statement. There was one of them live on TikTok. You have people that go
live.
And like you can discuss things with them. And this guy's live was named... Christian Democrats. And I ask, I'd never get on them lives. I don't, you know, it's a bunch of idiots yelling at each other. And even the ones that I may or may not agree with are usually just a bunch of idiots that have nothing else to do that are just yelling at each other. And they're like me. They're sitting in front of a screen and that's it. And they probably don't have much of an opinion. They probably, I don't know. I'm not going to assume much about them. I just don't join in.
Right.
I just, you know, keep scrolling on by. But this one I joined in, and first thing I ask is, how can you vote for somebody that's in favor of murdering children? I was immediately blocked.
Isn't that cute?
Immediately was kicked off the live and blocked.
That's just.
And I said, thank you. Thank you very much for blocking me. I appreciate it. That's the answer?
Yep.
That is exactly the answer. There was no discussion to be had. What that was some kind of little live chat room where he was trying to justify his choices. And only wanted somebody that agreed with him.
Yeah, of course, of course. And You. If you're the host of something, you, and you know you're in the wrong. That's the key. You have to have people that agree with you.
And that's your recourse.
Stroke your ego.
Well, that's your recourse, and that's your what you do when you know you're wrong, and you get in there. Yeah. And somebody questions you or brings up that as an argument or a point of discussion. I wasn't trying to argue with anybody. I just wanted to know.
Yeah.
Tell me your reasons. How can you look at this and say they approve killing babies in the womb up to and including 9 months at full term? This baby, I mean, how can you say that's good?
Right.
And claim yourself to be a Christian?
You know,
and I know you can give me the right scripture, but something about tying the big old giant rock up around your neck like a millstone and chucking it off in the water. You'd rather do that than to mess with God's children.
That's a real good paraphrase.
And we these fools are chucking themselves in the water millions of times a year.
Well, and speaking of which, look at who two of the speakers were last night. You had Slick Willie and Oprah Winfrey. You want to talk about pedophiles.
And you want to talk about, that's a good segue into the latest numbers from, they've lost in the last 3 months, 34,000 children.
More children. More.
That's than we
not
spoke
a total.
About. No, more than what we spoke about before. They've just now gotten new data, 34,000, over 34,000 more children lost.
Yeah.
Not lost. They're not lost. They came across the border.
Yeah.
And they got talked to and visited with.
And handed off.
They
handed
got numbers
off.
Either on their arm or on a wristband or in their backpack to an uncle.
Yeah.
And when the ones that were questioned asked, well, do you know the uncle? Uh-uh. And then uncle shows up in a big van.
Yeah.
And they handed them. That's not lost.
No.
I can't hand this to you and then go home and tell my wife, I lost my life.
Right.
I didn't. I gave it. I gave it to somebody else.
And
wish they were handing around lights down there, but they're not.
And here's the thing, man. You hand that light to me. Unless I tell you, you don't know where it is.
That's it.
And the sad part is, we don't know where not one of these kids are.
No,
we know what's happening to them.
They have found some of the kids. Yeah. And they're like in these child labor camps that are in the United States.
Yeah.
And they're working restaurants and food service in the United States. And they're being sex trafficked in the United States. And they're being sold to outside of the United States.
Have you heard the statistic?
And the United States is the biggest facilitator of the whole thing.
Have you heard the statistic? And I don't know the exact numbers. I wasn't prepared for this conversation. But the vast expansion of new child pornography that's hitting the internet since the Biden administration took over.
No.
It's massive.
I have not.
It's over 100%. Over 100% more brand new child pornography on the internet in the United States since that open border.
Dude, during the Biden administration, you had people having gay sex and filming it in Congress.
In Congress! Yeah.
In Congress.
Oh, my God. You had
training.
You had this dude, this dude flashing his boobies on the White House lawn. Oh,
after
Lord.
Being invited by our wonderful president. Anyway.
It's amazing. It's absolutely astounding.
It just blows me away, man. And you know, what problems do they have in Chicago right now? And I don't mean any particular group, Clay.
Right? No. The city as a whole.
The city as a whole.
Well, you got Brandon Johnson, the mayor, who is fighting against any common sense thing that could help the people of Chicago. He's all about little boys in little girls' bathrooms. He is all about, you know, the sex change and all that. He's all about providing. Taking money from the citizens of Chicago and giving it to illegal aliens.
Oh, I'll tell you what, how long is that going to last? Oh, it's lasted a while.
He's all about gun control, unless, of course, you're a gangbanger. The murdering, you know, what's the murder rate in Chicago now? 100%? I mean, it's ridiculous. It's amazing.
And that's kind of what I'm getting at. The problems I see in Chicago is you have homelessness.
Yeah.
That's a huge problem. You have a lot of hunger.
Yeah.
A lot of poverty.
Yep.
And you have violence everywhere.
And their police force is at like 40%.
See, so there's another issue. You have another problem with you know, undermanned police force. Mm-hmm. I'm sure undertrained police force.
Oh, yeah.
And you have all these real world everyday problems. And what do you do in your convention? You blow up a 20-foot IED birth control thing and put it out in front of a mobile baby killing machine.
There are women walking around in costumes dressed as abortion pills.
Wow. And then I saw something that was just, you know, the demonic, it's just there.
Yeah.
There was a guy and he was trying to do a little preaching while he was there. And of course they was giving him a real hard time. And one girl come over and she said, can I have one? He had some little pamphlets and just talking about giving your life to God and, uh-huh. and how God can forgive you of all your sins, any sin.
Including abortions.
And she said, can I have one of them? And he said, yeah. And of course she looked up.
Interesting.
There you go. She looked like she belonged on the left.
Yeah.
So anyway, They handed her one, and he started talking to her. She just took it, and you could just see the evil in her face, and she started eating it.
Yeah.
And she ate the whole pamphlet.
Yeah.
There she stood there and just and chewed it and swallowed it and got another bite, and the whole time just staring him down.
Yeah, she got the word of God in her.
That's what I thought. I thought, well, she got fed. She got fed. God's got his way. But just the unbelievable. And then another fellow was walking around, and he was talking to some of the pro-Palestine people, and just, and, you know, and he was trying to. And one guy wouldn't leave him alone. He kept cutting him in front of him. And every time he talked to somebody, he's like, don't talk to him. Don't talk to him. And he's like, I thought this whole group over here was all being inclusive
joy.
And loved everybody.
Where's
the joy? And they flat out said, well, you're from the other side.
Yeah. You know, it's amazing to me.
Let's divide us more and more.
One of the things I thought about during this, and I thought about it yesterday, as a matter of fact, how the left is stealing our vocabulary. Peace, joy, love, all of the, and they,
no tax on tips.
No tax on tips.
Oh, I won't talk about that.
Oh, there's so much more.
Did you see where she is going to help first-time homebuyers?
Yeah, $25,000.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
I think that is so fantastic.
For the home builders.
No, man, look. You take this person who doesn't have any money.
Right.
And you let, you
no income.
Them, no income. And you give them, give them.
Give them.
Give them.
Give them.
$25,000 to buy their first home.
Right.
You are an angel.
All right, let me ask you a question.
Come on.
Being an old construction hand.
Yeah.
Knowing Donnie Bates the way you know Donnie Bates. Love you, brother. Here's my question. Let's say you build this house.
Okay.
And when you get done with this house, fit and finish is perfect.
It looks
nice flooring. You got a stone fireplace.
Oh,
I mean,
it looks good.
This is a $250,000 house, right?
And not a very big one nowadays. But anyway.
Yeah. And you put it on the market. And you know that there is a $25,000 home buying credit for anyone that buys this house.
Mm-hmm.
Does not this $250,000 house now become a $275,000 house?
Oh, yeah. But where does she get the $25,000 to give to every
individual? Out of your back pocket.
That's it right there.
Out of your back pocket.
There you go.
Yeah.
We're not giving it.
No.
I'm giving away other people. Folks, if you'll call into our hotline right now, I'll give you all the money Clay has. But then you don't have a hotline.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Right.
You could promise all the vote for me. I'll give you Clay's paycheck.
That's right.
That's exactly it. These people are eating it up.
Oh.
They're like, oh, what an angel. She's helping people.
Yeah.
She's just helping people.
Full of joy.
Full of joy.
Yeah.
Full of joy. And her money, her hand is full in your pocket.
Yeah.
So tired of it, dog.
And so tired. And she's talking about, you know, because it works so well in California, she's talking about raising the minimum wage.
Yep.
Because
that worked dandy.
Oh, it worked so good in California.
Everything they've done in California has been remarkable.
Oh, yeah.
Remarkable failure.
Well, you know, Gavin Newsom ran on solving the homelessness issue.
Oh, I know. He has made a huge difference in
he
that.
He sure has.
He has
increased the homelessness.
By 100%.
Oh,
he's
doubled it. Oh, I'm telling
he's
you.
Doubled it. But he's got a new scam.
Oh, does he?
Yeah. The government, the people, are buying...
Yeah.
These little houses and putting them in these, and these little houses are like $6,500 for each home. And then they're selling them back
to the
government, which is the people,
yeah,
for $800,000+
each.
Each.
Yeah.
What a cool scam.
I'm telling you.
He's a genius.
He is.
And I wonder, now, I don't know the exact number, but California had like a surplus when he took office.
Oh, yeah.
Like 100. I want to say it was like up around 100 million.
Which is hilarious because the same thing happened in Minnesota when Tim Walz took office.
Yeah, they had a surplus too.
Yeah.
And now they don't. And I guess you got to come up with them 800 some thousand dollar scams to put back your surplus.
You know what? You know what?
Isn't he kin to somebody? Who's he kin to?
Who?
Newsom.
Oh, Pelosi.
That's right.
Yeah.
Nephew, right?
Nephew, wow. Yeah. You just came up with
Not
you didn't even realize it, but you just came up with a brilliant slogan.
Oh.
Yeah. The Democratic Party turning surpluses into deficits since 1952. Oh, man.
There you go, Dems. Knock on that. I don't know.
So let's keep talking about the demonic convention in Chicago. We had Bill Clinton and we had Oprah Winfrey, two of the...
Did you hear Sleepy Joe talk?
Oh, gosh. Let me say this. Very proudly, I want to say this. Oh, by the way, time out.
No.
You got to show these off. You know, these were a gift from one of our viewers. I think I know who it is, but I'm not 100% sure who provided these. I came home one day and they had been mailed to my house with my name and address on it. So it's somebody that knows me. But apparently that's a thing now. Our subscribers just randomly send us matching t-shirts, and I love it.
Yeah, I love it too.
This is what, the fourth or fifth one set that we've got?
Now, one of them I sent. One of them I brought over.
Okay, yeah. You did. And then one of them was the full armor outfitters.
Right, and then another one was the Israel one, and we both bought.
Yeah,
we bought that.
Well, but I'm talking about the ones that we've had.
Yeah, we've had several that been given to us.
Yeah, I came out from church and had that bag tied to my door handle on my truck. And then
I just think that is just neat.
I think I know where this came from, but I'm not 100% sure.
It comes from the heart of a godly
person. That's right.
It comes from the heart of a godly person.
So if I'm right, thank you so much, girl. And if I'm not, if it's somebody else, thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank y'all for just...
I don't even know who he's talking about, but thank you.
But
I want to talk about something different.
All right, come on with it.
We got hunting season coming up.
Oh, yeah, we do. Yeah, we do. And we got a new spot.
We got hunting season coming up. We got a new spot. That's exciting. I'm, watching the skies and seeing the birds. I'm watching the time change, too.
Yeah.
I'm watching because I take a ton of pictures, and especially in the morning. I love the sunrise.
I got to give a shout out to our buddy DJ.
We roped him into this. He's bringing burritos.
I know it. So our buddy DJ, young kid,
I love this guy.
Sharp kid, good kid, love this boy. Lloyd and DJ and I are in this group message because we all dove hunt together, and I came to the realization, just heart wrenching realization that opening day of dove season is a Sunday morning.
Yeah,
and I work on Sunday mornings. I'm a pastor, and so I sent out this tear-filled message to Lloyd and DJ saying, I'm going to miss opening day. And DJ's response was, well, hunt then church.
what I'm hearing is hunt then church. And I'm like, yeah, sunrise. I looked up future sunrise time. It was 7:08 on opening day.
Yeah.
I mean, 6:38 is shooting time.
Right.
And
so we get out there about 6 a.m. And that gives me a couple hours before.
Easy, yeah. And church is what?
I got to be there at 9. Okay. I got to be there at 9.
So you could leave the Dove Woods at 9 and make it by a little after.
Yeah, well, I got to be there at 9.
I know.
But
they're going to fire you.
True. And
they know it's opening day.
So Sunday, September 1st, I'm just going to let y'all know ahead of time, your pastor, those of you that are watching this that are members of Red River Cowboy Church, will be preaching in camouflage.
Amen. Amen.
And he accidentally volunteered to bring breakfast burritos.
Yeah, because, he said something.
He's
and
such a good kid.
We just roped him in between the both of us and our little wordsmith in there. We roped him in. And then he pulled up to work the next day.
Yeah.
Because he's out there now.
Yeah.
He pulled up to work the next day. And I said, so, hey, I stopped him. You know, I'm doing security and I stopped him. Like I'm got there. Had my shirt on. I stopped him. And he's, giggling at me. And I said, so, Mr. DJ, where are you getting your breakfast burritos at? And he's like, well, man.
La Familia.
And I said, well, I'll give you a couple choices. Then he said he really wanted to get it from that Burke place here that you took him to. The gas station.
Oh, right? Yeah.
The cafe.
Well, yeah, those are good. Bulldog Market.
There you go, Bulldog Market. And I said, either that or. Whataburger, La Familia. I said, there's a whole host. I said, Whataburger Taquito would be just dandy. I said, I just appreciate you bringing him. But what a good kid, though. He really is. He really is. I say kid, he's grown, man.
Yeah.
But, to me, he's a kid because I have boots that are older than him.
Well, when your age starts with a 2, you're a kid.
Yeah, you're a kid.
Yeah. Speaking of which, man. Oh, man. Lila Ruth. Mindy's grandbaby. You know, her daddy is Lofton, who's still in his 20s. This little girl. I get probably 10 or 15 pictures or videos a day of this baby. She is so precious, man.
I love it.
You know,
and you know, you look at that and you look at the joy you had. Mm-hmm. You just went like this.
Yeah.
You had so much joy. And these folks up there are just killing them. By the thousands, you know, dude.
It's funny.
How can you do that? How can you?
Yeah,
What is wrong with you? And then to wrap it into this perfect little thing, call it healthcare and women's rights.
Right.
Because who wants to take away women's
reproductive rights?
Who would want to take away any rights? And I hear these people saying, well, if Trump has his way, if you have a miscarriage, they're not going to let you abort that baby. That's not an abortion.
Such a lie.
There's a medical procedure that cleans you out. You can't leave a dead human remains inside somebody.
Yeah, because any doctor
they would die. Any doctor that did that would be sentenced to prison.
Well, and
you can't deny medical.
Let me get a little controversial here.
Okay.
Because they're lying about Donald Trump and his view on abortion. And here's the controversial part. I disagree with Donald Trump.
I do too, 100%. 100%.
Donald Trump is moderate on abortion.
Well, in my opinion, Donald Trump passed the buck on abortion. He didn't make a stand. He passed the buck. He said, I want to move it down to the states where it goes. And he did just like that. And you know what? Maybe in his position.
I agree and disagree with you somewhat. All right, here's the problem. Constitutionally, Donald Trump did the right thing. Because we are a federalist system, and a federalist system says that the states govern themselves.
Right.
And the whole point of the federal government is to provide security for the states and allow them to govern themselves.
Yes.
Constitutionally, that was the right, move. However,
morally,
I want to see an end to the abortion industry.
I would like to see him make a stand.
I want to see the abortion industry destroyed.
I want to see it treated exactly like if I went out
and murdered somebody.
Well, if I was driving drunk and I ran into a pregnant mother, she was 8 months pregnant, and I killed them both, I'd be charged with both murders.
Absolutely.
As I should be.
I want zero abortion.
When the baby dies, somebody needs to be held accountable.
Yeah.
Period.
I want zero abortion.
There needs to be a reason and a why. If there is a medical reason, then that's it.
Yeah.
But I'm with you.
Yeah.
Quit killing the children.
Yes.
Stop it.
And so,
and why anybody in the world would have to say, stop killing the children.
Right.
Why do I have to be this upset? I feel my blood pressure rising. Why do I have to be this upset to make anybody understand that killing kids is not a good thing?
No.
When did that become okay? It's became okay for a long time.
In Ephesians chapter 5, Paul says, be angry, but do not sin. There is a righteous anger.
And you're right.
And Jesus demonstrated that righteous anger when he went and cleared out the money changers in the temple. And if the wholesale slaughter of innocent babies doesn't make you angry, you're broken.
You are. And not only are they aborting them, but they're yanking them out piece by piece, and babies feel
and
pain.
And selling the parts.
There you go. They're doing it for profit.
Yeah.
They're killing children for profit.
Just amazing.
Anytime else you kill something for profit, kill a human being for profit, they call you a hitman.
Yeah.
And you go to jail for a long time.
I love this man. And I think outside of Ronald Reagan, he is the best president we ever had.
Amen.
But on the abortion issue, he's plumb wrong.
And he is. He is. And you know what? I'd sit down and have a discussion with him.
Yeah.
But I bet it'd be a discussion. I bet he wouldn't immediately block you.
Yeah.
Or say, you know, well, he's a lunatic because he thinks that.
Right.
I don't know. Anyway, let's get back to hunting. I want to talk about my light here.
All right. Come on with your light.
I'm excited.
You and your fancy light.
I got an electric bike for hunting.
So this goes on the bike.
Yeah.
I was wondering because I see this rail down here.
And the other part is already mounted on the bike.
Okay.
You take it off for easy charging.
Yeah, because this isn't handy by just like this.
Oh, no.
There's nothing handy about that.
I bought this light because the light that came on the bike is just, it's okay.
Yeah.
It's just okay. This bad boy is bright.
Yeah.
I mean bright. It'll light it up. But if you take you hunting and you turn that white light on that bright,
uh-huh.
you're going to chase everything in the woods forever away.
Right.
And so I've been looking on the internet.
For a green filter.
I wanted a light just like this, but with, I have lights with a little green diode.
In it. Oh, yeah, yeah.
I wanted one with the green, I didn't want the filter.
Yeah, okay.
The filters are, you remember the old filter, the red filter you put on your,
the little,
your brink? Yeah, you
the, put the, little, those military issue flashlights.
Yeah. You know, they're just so, they just don't work.
Yeah.
They just don't work. And you lose so many looms.
Yeah.
By putting that on, you're cutting your light down. Well, anyway, I saw this company, and I'm going to name this company.
All right. And we are not sponsored.
No, I'm not sponsored.
We're just bragging.
I saw this company on Facebook, and they were advertising their startup company.
I'm impressed because I will tell you there's been maybe half a dozen times that I bought something off of Facebook, and not one time has what I bought been worth the money.
Well, they not directed once. Me to where to buy this, and I didn't actually buy it off Facebook.
Okay.
But I saw it on Facebook, and it's Lamin X, LAMIN-X is the name of the company. And they had this light. They're a startup company. And this light is like supposed to be the brightest headlight for an e-bike or any bicycle that you can get. And it's like this. It's got its own battery. You charge it. I don't want something that's going to drain the battery on the bike.
Right.
I can get something to wire in, but that's more drain on my battery.
Right.
So anyway, I reached out to them on their Facebook ad and said, hey, I'm looking for a green light just like that for hunting. Do y'all have anything available or anything planned? And he said, probably in the future. You know, he answered me back pretty quick. He said, but you can go to Amazon and look up. He gave me the link, and it's a film. And I was like, oh, I don't know.
There's that filter.
That film. And, you know, a lot of these films, once you put it on something, then you better be right. And it's going to have stupid little bubbles under it. And
yeah.
You know, just think about the screen protector on your phone.
Right.
Well, so I was like, well, I don't know. And I done some research on it, checked it out. And then he messaged me back and told me that he said, this is not like an ordinary film. Like, and he mentioned cell phones or screen covers. He said, it's a super forgiving film. He said, you can put it on dry or wet. And I don't know if you've ever done any films like on a commercial sense with the, on a window.
Yeah.
And you put them on wet and they're super durable.
Right.
Just like that, man.
Oh, nice.
If I didn't have this on there so perfect, I'd peel it off. I should have brought the other because I bought too much on purpose.
Yeah.
It came in, you know, a 10-inch roll or a 20-inch roll. And I bought the 2-inch by 20-inch.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I think I gave like $10 or $12 for it. And you turn this thing on and it is bam.
Yeah.
It's bright and it is green.
Huh.
And I'm impressed with it. Tonight I go to work and I'll actually drive around with it, check it out.
Yeah, see if it scares away the raccoons.
The critters, the raccoons, the pigs, or the deer.
Yep.
I haven't been seeing many deer.
No.
It's just been so hot.
Yeah.
We've been over 100 every day.
Oh, every day. Every day.
I mean, it's still at 2 in the morning, it's still 85.
Well, today is being Thursday. Today is the first day of hotter than hell. For those that don't live in this area, hotter than hell is a bicycle race. Some of y'all think I'm just talking about this, so I have an excuse to cuss. I promise I'm not. The name of this bicycle race is Hotter Than Hell 100.
Yeah.
And it what they do is they start off at in Wichita Falls at the MPEC, which is the multi-purpose center, and it's 100 mile. The big race
endurance
is a 100-mile race during the hottest part of the year in north central Texas.
It is over 100 degrees and
miserable.
They start about 7 o'clock in the morning.
Yep, 7:05.
And they ride all
day,
miles, all day long,
all day long,
and miserable hot.
They've got water spots set up along the route. By the way, if you live in Burke Burnett, on Saturday morning of the hotter than hell. If you need to leave the house, you better do it now.
Yeah.
Because you are stuck.
I live in Burke and I work in between Burke and Wichita.
Right.
And only because of what time I get off, I can skeet by. I mean, I barely scoot by.
Yeah.
Because
they shut down the roads.
Yeah, they shut down the roads.
Police are out there with their lights and flashing and they shut down the road.
And if I leave, and I'm glad that Bob is the one who relieves me Saturday morning.
Yeah.
because he's always
On time.
On time or a little early.
Yeah.
So I'll probably leave. Well, I know I'll get to leave right at time to leave. I'll get right at 7.
Right.
And I'll be at the overpass I need to get through.
At 7:06.
7:06, and I'll be in good shape. I can skim right on through. Another 10 minutes.
Oh, yeah. You're done. Forget it. You're done.
You can forget it. And you're not getting by there for a few hours.
And see, this Saturday, I've got to be in Henrietta at 5 o'clock.
A.M.?
P.M.
Oh.
So I'm already figured. You still got stragglers at that time.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm trying to. I've already started thinking about what route I want to take to avoid.
At 5? Well, 4 o'clock.
I'll leave here about 4.
It's not going to be bad.
It won't be bad, but there's still potential.
You'll be able to skinny right out.
Glendale?
Yeah.
You think?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah, I think you will.
Maybe they'll have it all shut down by then. But, yeah, and the company you work for, Signal, does all the security for this event.
I know it. And I am so glad I work nights.
Mindy and Cujo.
I'm so glad I work nights.
Steve and everybody else, they are going to do 12 hour days, 14 hour days.
I know
it's brutal. I've worked it many times myself.
Yeah, you've worked it a few times that Brandy rode in it.
Yeah. Overnights.
And you know what? She didn't get to ride it this year.
No.
And
Or last year.
But
the year before she did.
I believe she's going to ride in it next year.
Yeah.
She's determined, and you know how she is. And I'm determined to let her be determined.
Oh, yeah.
I don't hold her back for nothing. I try to be the voice of reason. You can call me Jiminy Cricket.
Jiminy Cricket.
I remember Shauna. This is a funny story about Shauna. We were talking about she was little.
Shauna is Lloyd's daughter
that's in
the Navy.
She was the only other person on our podcast.
That's right.
She's coming by the phone.
That's right.
But she was little, and... I said something about the voice of reason, and she said, "Who's reason?" She was, and I said, no, it's the cricket. She said, "The cricket's name's not reason. It's Jiminy Cricket. It's not reason. Who is reason?" She was mad. She was mad because I would tell her who reason was.
That's funny. Oh, that's funny.
We had to watch the movie so she could grasp the voice of reason.
The voice of reason, yeah. The sad part is we don't have the voice of reason anymore in our country, in our world. And I'm glad I just said that. You know, we always talk about our country. It's not just our country.
No, it's the world.
It is the world.
Look at what's going on in London.
UK, you beat me to it, man.
God.
They are trying to put out a warrant for the arrest of Elon Musk.
Clay, they are making arrangements to remove actual criminals from the penitentiary to make room for the fake made-up criminals.
For the thought criminals.
The thought criminals. There's a guy that just last week got sentenced to 20 months because he posted on his Facebook page, "I'm tired of my money going to the illegal migrants."
There you go.
My tax money.
And that's hate speech.
And that's hate speech. And he got 20 months in jail for that. I'm not answering the door.
No.
And when you show up at the door and you want to take me to jail for that, we got an issue, man. That's not going to be the only charge. Coming down. That's not going to I don't want to just sit here and make no threat.
You and I have both said that there's a very strong possibility that we're going to go out in the hail of gunfire.
And so be it. But you're not locking me in jail because I said something.
No.
I mean, according to their whatever laws they're trying to institute now, just us talking about this would make us.
They're even saying they don't care what country you're in. If you violate their hate speech laws, they will extradite you and try you. I've never been to the UK. I've never been to England. And they're going to try and haul me over there and put me on trial.
Good luck.
Yeah.
We have the Second Amendment.
I love Nick Freitas. You know, he's the retired Green Beret.
Yeah.
And Nick Freitas had a little short about this that he did on YouTube, and it was funny.
You sent it to me.
Yeah,
it is funny.
Yeah, Nick Freitas says, the chief of police of London is going to extradite Americans. He says, "I'm a Virginian. It's been a long time since we've had a British invasion. I invite you."
Yeah, come on. We have the Second Amendment.
I'm telling you, man. I'm not going to knuckle under or bow down for any tyranny.
No.
From their government, our government, or anyone else.
Period.
Yeah.
Period.
Yeah.
I have certain rights that are granted to me by God.
Yeah.
And nobody but God is going to stop me.
Lloyd.
From exercising those rights.
I came into this world kicking and screaming, covered in someone else's blood, and I have no problem leaving the same way.
Exit stage left, baby.
You know, there's that old saying among veterans, just because I choose not to exercise violence doesn't mean I've forgotten how.
That's right.
And,
well, the meek shall inherit the earth.
That's right. And meek, I love Jordan Peterson's explanation of meek. Meek is someone who has a sword, knows how to use it, and chooses to keep it sheathed. That's it. Oh, man.
Have you seen, what's that idiot that got fired from the CNN? Lemon, Don Lemon.
Oh, gosh.
Have you seen him on the streets at the Chicago convention?
I have not, but I can only imagine.
He's walking around, and he's got his little microphone, and he's talking to folks. And
oh, yeah.
Who are you voting for? And he is getting a lot of people, especially from the black community, saying Trump.
Isn't that something?
He talked to an older gentleman. I really shouldn't say older because the guy's probably about the same age as me, or maybe a little younger.
You're a great grandfather, so.
So anyway, he was talking to this guy, and he said, "Who you vote?" He said, "Well, he said, economically and financially, I was much better off under the Trump administration." And old Lemon said, "No, you weren't." He argued with this guy what his financial situation is. No, you weren't. No, you. Oh, it just ate him up. He couldn't stand it.
And
he couldn't stand it. And what was really funny. As whoever was filming the whole thing, they released it all.
Yeah.
They didn't just release the cherry pick.
Brilliant.
They released it all.
So
they released the whole pile. And he is so frustrated. That's worth going and finding.
Oh, yeah. So in Pennsylvania, did you see this story? In Pennsylvania, there's this, I don't know where in Pennsylvania. I don't remember the name of the place, but there's this restaurant. It's real popular. They've got this sandwich they're famous for. They got TVs up with all the sports going on. And the patrons were in this place doing their normal thing, watching football, enjoying the day. And all of a sudden, the manager comes out, turns off the TVs, and says, "We're closing down for a private event," and put all these people out, kicked them out, emptied out the restaurant. And then all of a sudden, buses of people come rolling up, and all of these people go piling into that restaurant. And then here comes Kami Harris's
you almost said it.
Kami Harris's motorcade comes up. She goes in. All of the people that came in on these buses are actors.
Paid actors.
And she goes, because Donald Trump went into a bodega in Brooklyn, New York. Completely organic, completely natural.
I know, yeah.
This little black girl says, "I don't know what you're seeing on the news, but we love you, Mr. Trump." And he says, "Can I have a hug?" And it was all organic. It was all natural. And it was genuine.
It was beautiful, man. It was beautiful. It was the greatest thing I've ever seen. I've never seen nothing more beautiful. I love Trump, dude. I love him. I don't imitate for mocking.
And Kamala Harris bust in actors to try and replicate that. And the people outside,
done is a
the people that got kicked out of the restaurant are outside on the curb, and as she's rolling up, they're yelling Trump, Trump, Trump.
And there's a bunch of TikToks that were made.
Yeah,
and people made videos and post them on TikTok of them getting kicked out.
Yeah, it's amazing, just who so else? Artificial.
Who else robs and steals somebody else's stuff all the time and distorts it and makes it not them? I think the enemy does that with the
yeah,
word of God.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
I think that's just as soon as you start talking about that, that's what came to mind. No tax on tips. Anything Trump says, she wants to try to say it, but say it her way. No fracking in Pennsylvania at all. No, never mind. I didn't say that.
No, I'm all for fracking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She is just so.
The problem is there's so many videos out there of her saying that she's going to shut down offshore drilling. She's against fracking, open border. Did you hear about the 25% tax that she wants to put on all businesses?
No, God.
25%.
Well, you got to make extra money if you're going to give everybody $25,000. If you're going to give illegal migrants a $15,000 gift
Lloyd,
card.
You've been a business owner.
Yeah.
You had your handyman company pretty much, or yeah. construction company.
Right.
Let me ask you something. If the government took one quarter of your proceeds,
I'd have shut down in the first 2 months.
You'd have had to.
In the first 2 months, I would have went bankrupt. In now, 2 months. In 2 months, dude, I would have went bankrupt. I couldn't have made it, especially starting off, because at first we had equipment we were paying for. We had a lot of stuff we were paying for.
Dude, you were eating ramen.
Yeah, we didn't make any money.
Because it was 5 cents a package.
Me and Carl didn't make any money at first.
Yeah.
None. I mean, like, none.
No.
As a matter of fact, we both did side jobs
to
supplement our side jobs.
Yeah.
You know, that's we was literally doing painting jobs on the side that we weren't including in our company, because that paid better, because we had so much to pay for. And if the government would have come in and took an extra quarter.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wouldn't have made it. But they got to get that extra money somehow.
Price controls.
Oh, dude, that is so horrible.
It's communist. It's full-blown communist.
You can't. The government can't be the one regulating all this.
Did you hear what she said about the pharmaceutical companies?
Oh, snatch their patents.
Yes.
Oh, we'll snatch it. Somebody says, can you do that? She said, of course we can.
I can do that. And then she giggled. Yeah.
But you know what, man? I ain't got much love for some pharmaceutical companies. But that's because of the way the government does them now. It's wrong.
But here's the thing, man.
We fund all research.
It's still private business.
Right.
And when the government comes in and says, either you do what I tell you or I'm taking your business.
That's not a free country.
No, it's communism. It's full-blown communism.
Yep.
Everything... little by little, you know, it's funny. A week ago, we had nothing as far as a platform from her.
Right.
No idea of any policies. Then she came out with no tax on tips.
Stolen.
You know, brilliant idea. I wonder where she got it.
Yeah.
And little by little, she...
Well, she got it. Well, see, somebody else had said that before.
Yeah, somebody.
But see, a couple months before...
I wonder who.
Who was it?
Who was it? Couldn't have been Donald Trump.
It was Donald Trump.
Yeah.
It was. But see, when he said it... Because, I don't know why, but when he said it, it meant it was going to cost America
billions of dollars.
When she said it, it was brilliant.
It was brilliant and bold, yeah.
And it was for the people.
That's right. Joyful.
It must be the same joy they're feeling when they're killing children.
Yeah. Must be. And little by little, policies are coming out. And every one of them is right out of the Marxist playbook, man.
Did you see I think his name was Edwin. I think.
Okay.
Doesn't really matter. But there was a reporter, and he was at the Democratic convention. And he met a friend, and his friend was Edwin. Edwin was from Venezuela.
Oh.
Here illegally.
Yeah.
From Venezuela.
Yeah.
He's in Chicago, because that's where the United States shipped him.
Yeah.
Free charge. Gave him a free vacation to him. Chicago. He's living in a real nice motel. Anyway, he found him down around the convention, and he said, how come you're not inside? He said, I don't know. I hadn't gone inside. He said, let's go. So he took Edwin to the door. He said, me and my friend Edwin from Venezuela. He's an illegal migrant. He wants to go thank the people that let him in the country.
Hmm.
And they said, you got an ID? I know.
Yep.
He's from Venezuela.
Yep.
He didn't need an ID to get across the border.
No.
And he didn't need an ID to board the plane.
And he won't.
Flew him here.
And he won't need an ID to vote.
And he didn't need an ID to get all the benefits. What do you mean ID? She said, the little girl was very nice. She said, all you have to do is go apply for it. And he's like, fantastic. Come on, Edwin, let's go. And they marched him around, and there's a whole little place where you can go apply to get in there. They denied and turned him away because he wasn't a U.S. citizen. The guy said, Edwin, I am very sorry to say that the same people that let you in the country will not let you in to go thank them.
That's right.
You're not allowed
that's
in
amazing,
there.
Amazing, isn't it?
They built walls because walls work, and they require ID.
Yeah.
I don't know. Go figure. Everything is
Which
so
is funny because
irony,
the
man.
Same people said both walls and IDs are racist.
If you ask Edwin, they are. Edwin, and he was even denied applying. They wouldn't even let him apply to get
amazing.
In.
Amazing.
He couldn't even try to do it the right way. There is a right way to do things.
Yeah.
Applying and seeking it the correct way through the right channels.
Yeah.
and wasn't even afforded that opportunity.
It's amazing.
And it was absolutely because he was here illegally.
Hmm.
Wow. I don't get it, man. Right? So much irony, so much. It's laws for me, or laws for thee and not for me.
Joe Biden, at the beginning of his, well, during the campaign, before he was placed in office, not elected, but placed, Joe Biden, I remember him saying.
You can get this at on the Etsy shop. I
remember him saying, I would surge the border. Do you remember that?
Yes.
Surge the border.
Surge the border.
Yeah.
Oh, I also remember him saying that he was going to name Kamala Harris.
Yeah.
Man, it's hard.
Kamala Harris.
He just rolls off the
tongue. Kamala Harris. the border czar.
The border czar.
Yeah.
And she was like, yeah. And then they asked her, have you been to the border? She said, no.
I haven't been to Europe either.
I haven't been to Europe either.
And when she did go to the border.
And then she laughed, this cackle. God, that cackle.
When she did go to the border, she didn't go to the border. She went to El Paso, where they, before she got there, they moved all the homeless people out of the way, and they cleaned up the streets.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, polished the doorknobs and everything else.
Well, it's just like when they run all the homeless out of California because the Chinese were coming.
Oh, I know it. I know it. Just amazing.
And they cleaned them up. And, you know, Joe Rogan said something about it. He said, you know what's aggravating? Most aggravating thing about it, I used to live in that state.
Mm-hmm.
He said, now Joe Rogan got smart and moved to the state of Texas. But he said, all that could have been done for the people that live there. The people that own them businesses. All that could have been done. That could all been cleaned up. The city did that.
Well, here's the funny thing.
You could have done it a month ago, 2 months ago, 3 months ago. You could have maintained it like that.
Here's the scary thing about that.
Those people aren't important enough to do it for. But the leader of China is important enough to do it for?
Here's the scary thing about that. When they moved all those homeless folks out of there,
Where'd they go?
Nobody knows.
Nope.
Nobody knows.
Where'd they go?
Yeah. Soylent Green is made of people. did you know that Soylent Green was the setting of that movie? For those of you that don't know, Soylent Green was a great movie from the 1960s.
Yeah.
And it was a futuristic dystopian movie. Charlton Heston.
Yep, eating one another.
And it was set in 2022.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
We both recently watched it.
Isn't that funny?
And I say recently, within the last couple of years. And I did not know that it was set.
It was set in 2022.
Wow.
Yeah. Soylent Green is made of people.
Yeah.
Oh, man. All right. Lloyd, give us your tagline.
Oh, especially in this world we're living in now.
Especially now.
Take time.
Counteract what's going on in Chicago.
Yes. Take time to be kind. It takes just a minute. It's really not even that. Just take a second just to smile at somebody.
You know, it's funny you say that because this really stuck out to me. Yesterday, you know me, I'm always smiling. Yesterday, I went through the drive-through at a Sonic to get me my Route 44 unsweet iced tea, which I do about six times a day.
Yes, you do.
And I rolled through, and I pulled up to the window to pay, and there is this young lady in there, and I saw her, and I smiled, and her face just lit up, and she smiled back and waved.
I didn't even say a word to her. Speaking of the whole take time to be kind, I want to shout out to somebody I have made friends with.
Yeah.
On the social media platform TikTok.
Okay.
And I don't even know her name.
Okay.
Her son is a little big thing about that big.
Yeah.
And his road name is Cookie Monster.
There we go. Cookie Monster. Shout out to you, brother.
He is an autistic young boy. And he has certain challenges, but his hyper-focus is motorcycles and he bikers.
That's so cool.
And these bikers love this kid.
Oh, yeah.
He rolls up and he's the king. He just won his first bike show. And he's got it. Somebody gave him, bought him a little. This thing makes noises. It sounds like it's low.
Oh, yeah.
It is so awesome. And this kid is such a wonderful young man.
Yeah.
And shout out to his mama for being the mama he needs.
Yeah.
Just, you know, you watch all the ugliness and you see all the stupid stuff on social media and this will pop up on my timeline and I'll watch. And then I just switch over to her page and I'll watch video after video.
Isn't that fantastic?
And it's just, Some of it even brings you to tears. It's just so wonderful. The what stereotypical, this big, mean looking, ugly fool, tatted up and drives this giant hog and got earrings and whatever going on. And here he is with his kid, and he is so tender and so loving and nurturing, and it's so real and pure.
Yep.
And this kid is loves this guy or girls, and you know, it's all about just that community.
Yeah.
That community. And I'm telling you right now, man, every bike, all them bikers, when it comes to children and women, they're as safe as in the arms of the Lord.
Yeah, that's right. That's right, man.
And that lady said, you know, all them big old mean bikers, bunch of teddy bears.
Yep.
And she commented back. She said, the meaner they look, the better we like.
So there's this other kid on TikTok. I say kid. He's a young man. He's probably in his 20s. And he's got something going on, autism or something. And I follow his page. And his favorite character is Woody from Toy Story.
Cool.
And it's this big black kid. And people make and send him parts of the costume for Woody.
That's awesome.
And he'll model them.
That's awesome.
And
man.
This one lady sent him, you know, the whole outfit, and it was all legit. It wasn't, you know, wasn't that paper thin hot Halloween. She sat down at the sewing machine.
Yeah, yeah.
And she sent it to him, and he modeled it, and I stitched it. And so in my stitch, I had my phone set up on the window of my truck. I'm out in the country, and I'm, you know, dressed the way I dress. And I walk up to the phone while he's modeling. I give him a thumbs up. I said, "You're looking good, cowboy." And I posted that. And his mama responded to me, and she said, "Thank you so much. It just meant the world to him." I just love that, man.
That's
just
good stuff. There's a lot of good stuff in that.
There
a
is.
A lot of good stuff, man. I got to watch what I watch, especially if I'm – got to be careful what I watch, especially if I'm out there working. There's a lot of this stuff. I'll be sitting in my truck crying like a big girl.
Yeah.
And I'm supposed to be on security.
Right, yeah.
I'm supposed to be in security out there.
When that swarm of illegals show up and you're sitting there with snot in your beard.
Especially the soldiers coming home.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
And the puppies and the babies.
Oh,
and,
Lord. Older I get, the more emotional I get on all levels. Dude.
Yeah.
On all levels.
Yep.
To include my anger emotion.
Yep. Be angry, but do not sin. There's a righteous anger.
And there's
enough going on in our world today. Enough going on in Minnesota today. Enough going on in Chicago today that we should be angry.
Yeah.
We should be.
And if you're not, you need to check yourself.
We love y'all. God bless you. As always, we encourage you to like, comment, and subscribe. I will tell you that I looked at the analytics again this week. Man, the Google, they don't like us. Google doesn't like us. They are suppressing us. There are people that are subscribed to our podcast that don't get the notifications when we upload a new one. They have to go hunting
for it.
Go
look for it.
Yeah.
I don't get the notifications.
That's crazy.
And I'm on the podcast.
Yeah.
I'm connected to the thing.
That's insane.
And I never get them. I always have to go look. Yep. I haven't got one. Not one.
Help us beat the algorithm. Like, comment, and subscribe. Maybe we can push this thing out to a few more folks. Not because we're looking for likes, not because we're looking for accolades, but because we feel like we've got a good message that needs to get out
Amen.
To people.
We are
talking about the United States Constitution. We're talking about the Word of God. We're talking about being kind to one another.
Not a bad message.
No.
No.
And you know what? In all of our podcasts, neither one of us has ever murdered a child.
No.
Isn't that amazing? Imagine that.
I know.
Yeah.
I know. I was telling one of the guys out there at works where I do security, we were talking about the old gun control. And I told him all of my guns that I lost in a boating accident are defective. They were all defective.
Yeah.
Because even a couple of them were black. They didn't jump up and kill nobody.
No.
They just sit in the
gun cabin and
did
there.
Nothing. Did nothing.
Nothing.
Worthless.
Didn't even,
probably better off losing them.
That's right.
They were worthless. They were all defective. Every one of them. What are the odds that every gun I've ever bought was defective?
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt.
That's
God bless
luck.
You guys. Make sure you look out for those scary black guns. I'm telling you.
The ones wandering around.
That's right.
With the semi-automatic full clips.
That's right. They're as heavy as 10 moving boxes. God bless you guys. Lord willing, we'll see you next Thursday. And we appreciate y'all so much.